If you'd like to create your own shortcut, or maybe you want to modify the shortcuts that are in Final Cut Pro already, you can do that, believe it or not. Come on over.
Learning the shortcuts is vital if you want to increase your editing speed. For example, we can hold the tilde key to move or edit clips while leaving connections in place. But what if your favorite action doesn't have a shortcut? We're going to show you how to fix that right now. To view the standard shortcuts, navigate to Final Cut Pro, Commands, and Customize, or use the shortcut Option-Command-K. The command editor will appear. On the keyboard, we can click on a key to see the shortcuts associated with that key. And we can click on a modifier key, such as Command, Shift, Option, or Control, to see how the key colors update according to the associated shortcuts. If we want to find a specific tool or action, we'll use this search field. We'll search for Blade. The matching shortcuts will appear in the command list at the bottom of the viewer. And on the left, command groups allow us to filter by specific categories. Just keep in mind, the search bar will affect what's filtered, so clear the search to see all the results.
Let's go to the next step.
I'm sure you're wondering how to actually modify the keyboard shortcuts. So let's show you an example. Select an action in the list. When we click on an action, a brief description will be displayed on the right. Next, we'll press on a set of keys to set as the action's shortcut. For example, we'll give this color mask command a shortcut of Shift-Control-Command-C. If you're on the default set of shortcuts, this window will pop up, asking to create a new command set. We'll hit OK and create a name for the custom shortcuts we're creating. The shortcut appears to the right of Add Color Mask. We'll create a shortcut for the mask shape as well, with Shift-Control-Command-S. Now notice in the top left, we can see the name of the shortcut menu we're in. From here, we can switch to default. When you switch, be sure to click Save on all the changes you've made for the custom commands. We'll switch back to our command set. And we can even export our command set to share it with others. We'll leave the name as the one we chose, and we can either choose the folder to save it to or leave it as is. Then we'll click Save. We can also import command sets. Click on the menu again and select Import. Then choose the set to import. Click Open, and optionally type a name for the set. Then click OK. The new command set is now in our menu. We can also duplicate a set or delete one permanently.
What kind of shortcut modifications would you make? We'd love to hear in the comments below.
Don't forget to check out Pixel Film Studios, where you can find Final Cut Pro plugins designed for beginners and professionals alike to take your projects to the next level.
Like, share, subscribe, tell your friends, tell your neighbors.